to my channel. It's been a minute. I kind of disappeared, changed my identity, you know, with this new hair. Just kidding, not really. I just wanted to kind of change it up a little bit, but I've got a video today. It started out trying to be like a cut crease tutorial and ended up backfiring on me, but I still feel like it turned out okay. It's just definitely not a cut crease. So don't go into it thinking that that's what you're gonna get, because it's not gonna happen. Anyway, I really hope you guys like this tutorial. Let me know what you think, and yeah, let's get on with it. Okay, so today I'm starting out with my Photo Loving NYX primer. Gonna rub that all in my pores. Stuff always makes my face feel like a baby's bum. Seriously though, it does. Next, I will be taking my CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous. I am in the shade 205. And then I just dot it around my face. And then I'm gonna go in with a buffer brush. I like this kabuki brush that I have. And just blend it in where I want it to go. Then once I'm done with that, I take my, of course, Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer, and I do kind of the same thing. I just put a little bit on my hand, and then I take my flat brush, a little bit more, and I cover up those dark circles. That I have on my face. And then I just take my finger and I usually just pat these out. I feel like your finger is dense enough that it's not gonna like take too much of the product, because I kind of placed the product where I wanted it to go. So if you use your finger, then it kind of just blends it out nicely. The powder that I'm using today is my Fit Me powder in the shade 220. Is that what it? Oh, no, it's 205. I was like, oh my gosh! Which is funny because this is Maybelline and this is CoverGirl, so it wouldn't even be the same, but whatever. So I'm gonna take my Fit Me powder and take that same kabuki brush and then just set under the eyeballs. Then I am going to be taking my NYX Color Wheel Mosaic Face Powder, which is really funny because this is a face powder, not a bronzer at all, but I'm gonna use it as a bronzer because it's like way darker than my skin. Pretty much a snowman when it comes to skin color, so. So I'm just taking a giant blush brush, the one that I'm using, or angled brush, I guess. It's from Eco Tools, and I just get a bunch on there. And then you just wanna like do light circular motions and then up and like just in a line. But I like to blend it out, kind of place my product on there, and then blend it out. Get more if you need more. And then it's just like, settles that really beautiful. Begin a flat angled brush. I am using my Anastasia of Beverly Hills in medium brown. Just going to lightly fill those in.
Embarrassing.
And then usually I don't wear blush. I know that tons of people do. I don't really like it on me because I feel like I already have really rosy cheeks, but let's try it out today. I'm going to be using the NYX blush in Summer Peach. I like this color. I think it's like nice and neutral. So I just put that on the apples of my cheeks and brush it up. So now I'm looking really like I'm 12. I think that's what it is. That I already look really young, and so I don't want to do anything that makes myself look younger. I forgot to highlight, and I definitely want to highlight real fast. So I'm taking the Becca highlighter in Moonstone. This one's a cream one. So I just used my finger.
Don't buy brushes when you have fingers. Any slogan?
I think I just found a dupe for this Becca highlighter. Oh my gosh, I totally did. Okay, seriously, like this is, one's an eyeshadow and it's not cream. Well, it's kind of cream, but like I just swatched it on my hand and they look almost identical. Okay, if you're looking for a really good highlighter, this one, Moonstone, which a lot of people use. If you want like a cheaper version, this is Supermodel by Colorpop, and it's literally like could be the same exact color. Oh my gosh, seriously, it's the same. That's awesome. What you gotta do? Okay, you're welcome. In advanced. I'm actually going to be using this today on my eyelids. I'm going to prime my eyelids first with my MAC Paint Pot and Painterly. I'm just going to put that all over my eyelid and a little bit under my eyelid because I'm going to be putting some eyeshadow there as well. And I definitely want to make sure that that stays where I put it. I'm going to set it with some just regular colored, like close to my skin color, eyeshadow. Okay, so first off, I'm gonna get like a light tan color that pulls a lot of orange. This one is just going to act as a great transition shade. The one that I always use is Burlap from my Lorac Mega Pro palette. And I am going to outline my crease. I'm going to be taking a smudgy brush and I'm just going to smudge out that line, make it real smoky, but I'm trying, like, just, you gotta remember to try and keep it off of the lid. So when blending, do not blend towards the lid, you're gonna wanna blend circles out. Okay. Next layer, we're gonna go a little bit darker. I'm going to go into this color, Dreamer, which is just a darker brown. Right here, this one. The next step, this is gonna sound kind of weird. We're gonna go back into our paint pot that we started with in the beginning. I'm gonna take this with this little tiny brush, dip it in this, carve out my eyelid. with a white eyeshadow. The one that I'm going to be using today is the one from my Laura palette, so just go in with a white matte eyeshadow. And I'm going to pack this to set where I already had that color. Then we're gonna blend the crap out of this. So get your blending brush ready. I'm taking my MAC 217 and I'm going to blend the crap out of it. So I'm gonna be taking this Colorpop eyeshadow that's like super gorgeous. It's in the shade Supermodel. And I'm going to be packing this onto the lid. I'm going to take that same dark brown color and I'm going to put it on my bottom eyelash line. And then I'm going to blend it out with a blendy brush.
Blend it good. Blend it good, good. Blend it.
Then I'm going to add some liquid eyeliner with my fave black liquid liner. You guessed it. NYC!
NYC! Your heart is your destiny. $3, $2, one me.
And then I'm gonna add some mascara to my eyelashes. I don't know why I always do this, but I always like to go and deepen up the crease after I'm done putting on my mascara. So I'm gonna actually take a matte black eyeshadow on a flat angled brush, and I'm gonna go deepen up that crease.
Hopefully I do not do that.
Then I'm going to add my lashes, and let's pray that these go on smoothly.
Do some dance moves, dance moves, dance moves, dance moves.
Okay, I think we're ready. Just slap it on there, just do it. Oh, it's staying so much better this time. Okay, it's feeling kind of loose. No. No. I'll give this one a break. Yeah, do you see that? That's like my worst pet peeve. That angle right there. It's like this.
Taken on by a thread. Get it? There's a thread on here.
For my lips today, I am using Tulle by Colourpop Cosmetics. It's a little baby one. Look how cute. My video for you today. I have decided that I'm going to start uploading every Tuesday. That gives me like enough time, I think, to get a good video edited and everything. And I just want to make sure that I'm putting out quality more than quantity. And so, anyway, if you like my video, be sure and subscribe, like, comment, let me know what you guys want to see next. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot! I reached 100 subscribers, and I don't know if you could tell, but I'm so stoked. Until next time, guys, love you. Bye. Oh crap, I did that whole thing with gum in my mouth. Whoops.